Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. If you don't already know me, my name is Marilyn and I am a streamer on Twitch. Today I'm going to be talking about tips that I wish I learned on Stardew before I started playing. These tips are going to be beneficial for anyone who really just started Stardew Valley or have been playing it for years. So I'm really excited to share it with you guys. If you guys want to see any of my Stardew Valley gameplay, I will have all of my previous streams uploaded on my YouTube VOD channel that I'll have linked below. And if you ever want to catch me live, I will also have my Twitch link below as well. But let's jump right into the video. The Stardew Valley Wiki will be your best friend. If you're trying to complete the game, the Wiki will help you kind of figure out what's going on to see what you need to do next to complete the whole entire game. But beware because there will be spoilers. So if you're someone who doesn't enjoy reading spoilers, never look at the Wiki because there's a lot of spoilers in Stardew Valley. But even if you're playing the game casually, some people like to read ahead so that they could figure out what scenes they want to unlock and what friendships they want to pursue and things like that. So, specific days in Stardew Valley. Once you really start getting into the game, you kind of start memorizing what happens on certain days. But I'll give you guys just kind of the rough rundown. On Wednesdays, there's going to be a new cooking recipe every morning or daytime that you can get to learn a new recipe. And if you miss Wednesdays, then you can learn Wednesday's recipe on Sunday. Fridays, you can go visit the traveling cart, and I recommend anytime you visit the traveling cart to double check what you need for the community center, because there'll be time to times when the travel cart will have items that you need for the community center. And also, I highly, highly, highly recommend that if there's a rare seed in there, you buy it. Even if you have only 1,001 coins and the rare seed is worth 1,000, I say buy it because once you plant it and grow that plant, you'll make a lot more money from it. And then you can always multiply that plant by putting it in a seed maker. So I definitely recommend buying rare seeds anytime you see it. Tuesdays, Robin is closed. So if you're trying to move houses around, if you are trying to build something, if you're trying to buy stones or wood, anything like that, Robin is closed. You guys don't know how many times I've taken a trip down to Robin's or up to Robin's and she is not open because she goes to the gym. She goes works out with everybody on Tuesdays, so she won't be working. And every day, I believe up until you finish the community center, Clint closes at 5 p.m. I believe it's 5 p.m. or it might be 3 p.m. I'm going to double check that. So make sure to break all your geodes with him before he closes. The geodes could help you find extra artifacts to help you complete the museum quicker. And usually when I go visit Clint, I like to bring other artifacts that I found digging up and bring it to Gunther down at the museum. What to do on your spare days? I would say for early game advice, the best things that you could spend your time doing is gathering more resources. Going to the mines, going fishing, go foraging. All of those things can help level up your skills, and you can never hurt to have more resources on the farm. Make a checklist or log your task. I highly, highly, highly recommend making a checklist because it's really freaking cool to look back on it when you complete everything. Or you can log your task and just daily things that you need to do within Stardew Valley that could really help you keep track on what to focus on. Because once you really start getting into the game, it can get really overwhelming on what to focus on, and then you kind of forget sometimes when you need to do certain things. So logging your task will really help you figure out if maybe you need to give a gift to a villager on their birthday, or if you need to finish a quest on time before the quest ends. So things like that, I think it'll really help you stay more organized within the game. Salmon berries and spring onions. I highly recommend to forage for spring onions because I believe they grow all spring and you can find them north of your farm. And also for the salmon berries, you can forage them from spring day 15 to 18, I believe. And both of these items can help you gain more energy as you go throughout your game. Or if you need it, you can help. You can sell it so you can make more money from it. What to sell and keep in Stardew Valley? One of the most difficult things that I had to figure out when I played Stardew Valley was what do I sell? What do I keep? You know, you kind of just want to keep everything, but at the same time, you need money, you know, you need space. It kind of gets overwhelming having all of these items. So a rule that I kind of followed by was anytime I had multiple items, I would look at what kind of star the item had. So I would sell the gold stars or any of the colored stars of that item, and I would keep the non-starred ones. Obviously, if I only had an item that had a starred item that was starred, then I would just keep it. But if I had non-starred items, I would hold on to those, because then you can just give those items to villagers throughout the year or use it for any recipe, and the starred items actually give you more money in the end. So that's just something that I did. I know other people have other opinions on what to sell and what to keep, but I think either route you take will be fine. You can visit the spa. I feel like some people may not know about this, so I thought I should add it in. But you can actually regenerate your energy at the spa. It does take time, you know, walking up over there, sitting in the pool, and then coming back down to whatever you're doing. But that is an option that you have if you don't have anything to eat to gain back your energy. Farm at the Cinderace Forest. You can get a lot of resources there, such as stone, fibers, and trees, and they don't take too long to respawn. So I would recommend just visiting the Cinderace Forest anytime you can. Cinder Sap Forest anytime you can. And every couple of weeks, those resources will respawn and you can gather even more. Items you should get from Robin. I highly recommend getting the calendar, because early game, you can keep the calendar right next to your bed in your house, and it kind of acts like the bulletin board at where Pelican Town is. So every day, if you have the calendar, you can just click on it and it can show you ahead of time, like what events are coming up, whose birthday it is. So the calendar really helps with, especially with birthdays, because you wake up in Stardew and you go to the calendar, you see, oh, today is Evelyn's birthday, and you're like, okay, I'm gonna grab a rose for her, or a flower, because I think she likes flowers. You can grab a flower from your farm, and then when you walk into the town, you can give Evelyn her flower. The workbench is highly, highly, highly recommended. It pretty much gives you access to materials in any adjacent chest. And let me show you guys how mine looks. This is how my setup looks, and I think this is the most optimal way to make use of my workbench. Get yourself a telephone. It can be used to check store hours before you go visit the store, and it's also fun to have because sometimes NPCs will call you on the phone. Fence in your animals. This actually helps you a lot in the morning, because if you already have them fenced in, then every morning it's easier, it's quicker for you to just pet all of the animals at once. You don't have to go like walking around for them on your farm, and that will give you more time to do other things in the game. Trash is treasure. If you go fishing and you find trash, hold on to it. If you have crab pots that give you trash, hold on to it, because once you make your recycling bin, you can go ahead and put that trash into the recycling bin, and it will generate you something of, it'll give you a resource, it could be like coal or wood. So definitely hold on to your trash. This next tip I've actually never tried myself. I've only heard about it, but I thought it was pretty useful. Pretty much it's where when the next season comes, usually all of the hoed up area that you had for your plants in the previous season are gonna disappear. But this trick is, if you have any extra mixed seeds, you can go ahead and plant those the day before the new season starts, so that when the new season comes in, those mixed seeds will grow and then die, because it's a new season, and then you can go ahead and just cut off the dead plants in the morning, and that actually will save you a lot of time and energy, since you don't have to hoe it up and you don't have to spend your energy hoeing that area up. So we've come to the end of the video, and I really hope you guys enjoyed all of my tips. Let me know down below in the comments which tips you like the most, and which tips you plan on using. And if you have any other tips, please feel free to share it. I'd love to know it, and I'm sure everyone else will too. But anyways, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.